I'm standing outside on the north side of Clarksdale, outside one of Clarksdale's small businesses, Tony's Barbershop. I've been coming to this barbershop for a long time. This is where I get my haircuts, my trims. I used to have locks on my head, so I used to get my little line, you know, to be fresh when I go out into the public. But now, as you can see, I cut my hair off. So on Friday, this is where I get my trim. It happens to be Friday that we shoot this video. So we're going to go inside for a minute and see what they talk about in Tony. This is a barbershop talk going on. Come on, let's go. This is a typical Friday in Tony's barbershop. Everybody's just sitting, waiting. Some people in the chair, getting a haircut. What's up, little man? What's going on? This is my boy Rico over here, chopping up. No, we were asking classmates. This is my boy Jay Mike over here in his corner. I was his drum instructor at Clarksdale High, talking percussion. You know, he was so generous, he made up a little rap for me. You know, I thought it was pretty cool. Go on, hit a little line for me.
B-Fell,
and we gon' vote for B-Fell, if I hit the ball. I like that, you know? This freestyle, man. It's a lot of skills up in here, you know? This is actually my barber right here. AKA Rocky. You see him just getting them eyebrows. Look at him. He's very persistent in his etching of those eyebrows there, you know? And he's also a proud alumni member of my alma mater, Mississippi Valley State University. You can just take a picture of that right there. Yeah. So that is my alma mater. I'm proud of it, man. Keep doing your thing. I need a cut too, man. I'm coming back. My partner right here, Danko. Danko over here chopping up. My cuz up in the chair right here. So he getting his trim up. And we got Kim. We got a new addition to Tony's Barbershop up in here. We got Miss Kim Green. So we're here with the owner of Tony's Barbershop. What can be done to increase your business and the community growth around as a community advocate?
Well, actually, two things. We need better tax incentives as small business owners. We definitely need to work on the infrastructure, because the more businesses you can get to come in, actually, you can actually drive the taxes down because you have more people putting into the pot. It's just like simple math. The more you add, the more profitable you can get, become. It's just simple. I don't understand how we let so many jobs leave us. And it affects people on a daily basis. I mean, Lord has blessed me to have this shop here since 1996. And we're in the heart of the community. And we try to have the community at heart. But as a small business owner, you can only do so much. You know, it's rough out here.
And one final question I want to ask you. I know that you're not a voter here, but it's obvious that you expect the lives of many people out here, because there are plenty of voters who bother here. But as a community leader, what you know about me and how I've been able to be in the community, donating to the Mayside 5% for the scholarship ball, and being an advocate for you, bringing artists here like Marcus Sapp, Rance Allen, and you in the industry yourself, so you understand the importance of outreach, wouldn't you?
Right.
Would you give me your snap of approval to you think that I'm qualified change
process
around as a young, intelligent mayor
candidate who needs to see the process? Yes, I do, because, first of all, it's sad to say, but sometimes you don't need ties to be able to come in and actually change. A lot of people have been called and have to leave, come back to leave. You know, and you can't look at a man because of his age and say that he's not qualified to do a job. I opened my business when I was 24 years old, and I've been open ever since. So age is not nothing but a number, but it's the maturity of level of the person who's in charge. And I do give you my stamp of approval, because I've seen the things that you've done. I've seen how you reach out. I've seen how you try to help. Mayor here. I've been here since 1996. I've only seen him in my shop four times. Each time it's just to put up a campaign sign. I had to ask him, how's the community, how things going? But it never came about. You know, not saying that because you're a patron of ours, but you actually do come in, go around and check on the people, check on the children, check on some of the sick and shut in over there. I've never seen them do that. And see, to be a leader, you first must be compassionate.
You might have a heart.
You don't have a heart. You can't truly be a leader. Because you got to understand, and you can't just, because you get to a certain level, a certain stature, forget from whence you came. You must always remember from whence you came. I know it's a lot of people that have a lot of money. Money doesn't tell a person's character. It just unveils it.
Well, Tony, I know that you're busy. You definitely have a we are 85% African American here in Clarksdale, and not to deteriorate, we're interracial in a sense, because we're definitely far by not racist. But that's a big statement to come to our own community to reach out to see that change is definitely needed here in Clarksdale. Ooh, child, things you get right.